Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Ever-living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul, into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attentive to the signs that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. God's temple in heaven was opened, and the ark of his covenant could be seen in the temple. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and on her head a crown of 12 stars. She was with child and wailed aloud in pain as she labored to give birth. Then another sign appeared in the sky. It was a huge red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on its heads were 7 diadems. Its tail swept away a third of the stars in the sky and hurled them down to the earth. Then the dragon stood before the woman about to give birth to devour her child when she gave birth. She gave birth to a son, a male child, destined to rule all the nations with an iron rod. Her child was caught up to God and his throne. The woman herself fled into the desert, where she had a place prepared by God. Then I heard a loud voice in heaven say, "Now have salvation and power come, and the kingdom of our God, and the authority of his anointed one." The word of the Lord. The queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold.
The queen stands at your right hand, arrayed in gold.
Hear, O daughter, and see. Turn your ear. Forget your people and your father's house. So shall the king desire your beauty, for he is your Lord. They are born in with gladness and joy. They enter the palace of the king. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through man, the resurrection of the dead came also through man. For just as in Adam all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to life, but each one in proper order. Christ, the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. Then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to his God and Father, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he subjected everything under his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Mary is taken up to heaven, a chorus of angels exults.
Gospel according to Luke. Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For that moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears. The infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believed that what was spoken to you by the Lord will be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord. Malipayon nga kapistahan sa Assumption sa aton tanan. Para pa ka nato ng Ginoo. Mga utod, naibaluan ta naman nga ang piyesta sa Assumption. Among si Maria gindala pahagto sa langit. There's a basic difference between the ascension and the assumption is that ascension, referring to the Lord, of course, he is the one by his own power ascended into heaven. Because Jesus is God, he ascended by his own power and by his own accord to heaven, back home to where he came from. In theology, we call that the exitus reditus, no? The coming in the going in the coming back of Jesus to heaven. And Jesus also mentioned that he came from the Father and he will go back to the Father on his own power, because authority was given to him. Now, assumption on the other hand is that this is the gratuitous will of the Father, of God. Mary did not went to heaven on her own power. Rather, it was the fulfillment of what is to come. That's why if you read the commentaries on the Feast of the Assumption, it would always tell us that this feast reminds us of that hope that all of us have. And what is that hope? The hope that we go back to the God, that the hope that we go back to our real home. And that real home is with God. Tinga si ang mahal na Eloy ang mga naguna. Well, of course, because she is the disciple par excellence, which means that she is the disciple, the perfect disciple whom we ought to emulate, whom we ought to follow. Te ang ato nga destiny, our destiny is to be like Mary. If we follow in her footsteps, then our end will also be like Mary. In other words, the assumption is already the reality of what is to come for us. Nga ano, nga ang natabo sa mga ni Eloy, nga gindala siya palangit, amo man ang matabo sa aton, nga ginalauman naton sa katapusan sang panahon. The perfect obedience of Mary, and by the grace of God, merited her to be the first fruit after Jesus in fulfillment to what the scripture said, that the last enemy to be destroyed is death. And the assumption is a reminder for us that as disciples, someday, in God's time, by the power of God, we too will be united with the Father. Because after all, this earth is not our home. We are just on a pilgrim journey here on earth towards back to the Father. Ang aton nga masubo nga panahon, subong ang mga sa aton nga moderno nga panahon, the devotion to the Blessed Mother has waned. Matanaw niyo, no? Sa una, sa gandalag po kamo, especially those of you who are already in their, shall we say, late 60s, you have really experienced how the Catholic Church is filled with so much devotion to the Blessed Mother. We admit that there are some abuses in the devotion, that sometimes Mary has already upstaged Jesus. That's why the Second Vatican Council wanted to have our devotion to Mary with a Christocentric orientation. And that is expressed in the Marianis Cultus of Paul VI. The Marianis Cultus. Kaya natabo sa una na though si Maria na lang ang tanan, mawala na si Jesucristo. Unfortunately, the unforeseen effect of this is that instead of reorienting the Marian devotion, ano natabo? Nadula ang devotion nato sa mga Eloy. And that is precisely the reason why the young people nowadays, I do not know, maybe you can check your children and grandchildren, how their devotion to the Blessed Mother is. If ever they still have devotion to the Blessed Mother. Many of us have this nostalgic memory. Kita tanan, no? Especially in our age now, in our generation. Ngano? We have come to love our faith because of the devotion to the Blessed Mother. For example, ako yan, no? Hindi magkita ko yan panapagto sa Flores de Mayo ng ina. Okay? Gatulog ako nung buwanis ang gamay ako. Pero I remember sweet memories of Mayflower festivals. Because it was the time na simple catechism. Also during October, nga on that day, on those days of the month of October, our school will always make us pray the entire rosary. Kaya matamat na siya, kada period lang, isa ka mystery, hasta nga maubos naman ang isa man ang ka mystery, ang minang good joyful lang sa isang adlaw. Ibang ganiaya, apat ka dyan, no? Isa muna sa amin, isa man lang. Pero, you know, it makes me realize nga those simple activities brought me to have a deeper faith in God. Di kabay pa nga sa ato ng mga panimalay, ang mga na matabo, no? We recover the beauty of the Marian devotions. Second, which I think is important also, is the idea that this world is not our home. And the assumption reminds us of that. We are filled with so much fear and uncertainties during this pandemic. Tanawin niyo ba lang ubra sa ato, no? Una-una, alcohol lang. Hindi mag-mask kay total. Hindi magkaya lang mask. Sorry, alcohol, tapos face mask. Mas hindi nga optional na lang face mask, ah. Kung gusto niyo, kung healthy ka man lang, okay lang na. Hindi, kung hindi ka healthy, hindi ma-face mask eh. Sorry, mandatory na. Ma-face mask ng tanan. Subong, ma-face shield na ta. Mas nasun balabulan, ma-raincoat na ta. Tabunan na ng bilog, kalawas na. Ay, nako, Lord. Anyway, whatever they're going to do with next month, I do not know. For example, ang klase. October 24, abrihan ang klase. Ginigin ko naman, October 4 na naman. There are so much uncertainties. Gusto buto? Well, what we can do? What else can we do? Wala tayong magawa. We follow. Pero it shows to us that this world is filled with uncertainties. This is a valley of tears. And all the only recourse that we have is to know that Mary, whose faith in God is profound, will also remind us that in the same manner that she believed in the power of God, in the promises of God to be fulfilled in her life, it should also be true to us. In her Magnificat, she said, that God has fulfilled His promise to Israel. And I think that is also the faith and the hope that we have. Whatever tomorrow brings, the Lord will always be there for us. He will always protect us. And ultimately, He will bring us safely back home in heaven. Amen. Please all stand. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Raised body and soul to glory, Mary shines forth as a great sign of our eternal future as the Church. As pilgrims still journeying towards the heavenly kingdom, let us bring our prayers with her to God our Father. As we say, bless us in our life journey, O Lord.
Bless us in our life journey,
that as a church we may look forward to the resurrection promised by our Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Bless us in our life journey, O Lord.
That world leaders may become instruments of peace among nations. Let us pray to the Lord.
Bless us in our life journey,
that Christians may find unity around Mary, the lowly handmaid, exalted to glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Bless us in our life journey, O Lord.
That the sick may see hope in Mary's glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Bless us in our life journey, O Lord.
That the dead may rise with Christ to rejoice with Our Lady and the saints. Let us pray to the Lord.
Bless us in our life journey, O
Lord. Lord of heaven and earth, our prayers come before you with the help of our glorious Mother, the first believer called to share in the glory of her triumphant Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy Church.
May this oblation, a tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the most blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assumed into heaven, may our hearts aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We give them all to
the Lord. Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty in our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, to Jesus Christ our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your Church's coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body, she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of our life. And so in the company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
This is the chalice of my blood,
the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Patricio, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, with the Saint Sebastian, Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the honor, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity. In accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ. Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we ask you to grant, O Lord, that through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assume into heaven, we may be brought to the glory of the resurrection through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please all kneel for the Oratio Imperata.
God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has claimed lives and has affected many. We pray for your grace for the people tasked with studying the nature and cause of this virus and its disease, and of stemming the tide of its transmission. Guide the hands and minds of medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion, and of those government and private agencies that must find cure and solution to this pandemic. We pray for those afflicted, may they be restored to health soon. Grant us the grace to work for the good of all, and to help those in need. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Mary, help of all Christians, pray for us. Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Please all stand. Announcement. This is related to the call of the CBCP for the Church in the Philippines to be united in prayer against the pandemic that we are experiencing now. We are asked to pray 10 Hail Marys every noon time. Siguro kung nag-Angelus ka mo, para tapos sa Angelus, you add 10 Hail Marys. It will start today and it will end on September 15. And that is the Feast of Our Lady of Sorrows. Nagsala ako kagapon. I was thinking, Exaltation of the Holy Cross. So it will end pala on the feast of Our Lady of Sorrows. So it will start Assumption, and it will end September 15, Our Lady of Sorrows, 10 Hail Marys at noontime. So I hope we can spend some moments in prayer throughout this month, no? As designated by the CBCP. So thank you very much. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God, bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Yes.
Let us praise the Lord and the Blessed Mother. Happy feast to all of you.